Hey guys, welcome to TechHub. Let's check out this video call. It's a one of those real life lore videos that I've been reacting. You know, I've been getting quite a few views for this. Not on every video, but it's and also like I love this content. You know, I love to react to this stuff. Last time was like literally blew my mind. It was called Impossible Things That Can Happen on Other Planets. It was literally mind blowing. I'll put that reaction at the end of this video. But today we're gonna take a look at this thing with the 24 million views on this. These videos have like shitload of views, okay? And this video is called How the World Map Looks Wildly Different Than You Think. And I don't know much about the geographical thing about our planet Earth, that not that much. You know, if you're going to go deep into our world, it can really confuse you. Okay. And let's find out. It's a very small video. It's 6 minutes long. It's going to be fun. Okay. And the next video is like 20 minutes long. It's crazy, man. I don't know about that, but let's just react to this thing. How the world map looks wildly different than you think. How does it look? Let's find out. Okay, let's do it. 3, 2, 1, let's go. And if you like this reaction, please subscribe.
The map of the world is...
Bitch, okay. If you like this reaction, please subscribe and show me support. And if you have any videos that you want me to react to, please type down in the comment section. I'll definitely note it down and react to it. And I'm getting really tired of doing these reactions. They don't provide me any like subscribers or, you know, views or anything. I'm about to abandon pretty soon, but I don't know. We'll see. If you like this reaction, subscribe. Okay, well, let's go. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
The map of the world is a lot stranger than you think it is, especially this map. You've probably seen it a lot in classrooms or office buildings, but this map is extremely, very badly wrong. As we can all hopefully agree upon, the Earth is a sphere, and that means that it is impossible to accurately depict...
That whole map is completely, covered around the fucking ball of Earth, okay?
Earth's surface on a two-dimensional map. This particular common map is called the Mercator Projection, and if you'd like to experiment with countries for yourself, please go to this website called thetruesize.com after this video to see what I'm talking about. Let's take the U.S. state of Wyoming as an example. Under the assumption that Wyoming is actually a real place and not a land full of tumbleweeds with a population less than downtown Baltimore, this example will work perfectly because of the state's square shape. As we stack one unit of Wyoming on top of each other, we get more and more distorted as we approach the North Pole to the point where we don't even really recognize its familiar, boring shape anymore. When we move our Wyoming stacks south, they get more squished together as we approach the equator. This will happen with every other landmass in the world, but first, let's take a look at some other US states. They say that everything is bigger in Texas, but what is Texas itself bigger than? Moving the borders over to Europe, the answer may surprise you. Texas is much bigger than Spain and Portugal put together, and is also even bigger than France. But Texas is only the second biggest US state behind Alaska, which seems absolutely gargantuan at the top of our map. But while Alaska is large, it isn't that large. Taken down to the US mainland, it compares like this, and taken to Europe, it looks like this. And while we're here...
Honestly, Alaska looks like a scary, almost looks like a human, like a face there. It looks like it has a face on it. Kind of looks like Master Chief from the Halo games, you know? And what is it with this shit? Is this supposed to be beard? I don't know. But I like it. It's actually kind of scary looking. It's weird. And also, like, it looks really big. Dang.
Europe. Let's take the time to understand how much bigger Europe seems than what it actually should be. Let's start by taking France and moving it down to Africa to get our first glimpse at this. The United Kingdom seems pretty large as well, but let's take India and move it over to see just how small it really is.
India, my India!
The United Kingdom is actually smaller than quite a lot of places in the world that you might not expect. Places like Japan, the Philippines, Sumatra.
I like this video where he's comparing the sizes. I thought it was going to be something else, but this is very interesting.
Madagascar and New Zealand. Next door to New Zealand is
New Zealand look just like Japan. What's
Australia.
Up?
And the UK looks so small just off the east coast in comparison.
Compared to Australia,
and
those
Australia,
things are nothing.
In fact, is much
and United Kingdom looks like Mosquito, what's
bigger than most people believe it to be. It can be placed to cover almost the entire continental U.S. Interestingly, the combination of the following countries will not cover that same area.
Dang.
Portugal, the Netherlands, Estonia, Albania, Hungary, Belgium, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Austria, Croatia, Latvia, the Czech Republic, Serbia, Switzerland, Slovakia, Lithuania, Denmark, Ireland, Greece, Bulgaria, Romania, the United Kingdom, Italy, Germany, France, Spain, and Norway. And that's not factoring in big, but not too big, Alaska to the north.
Alaska.
Between Alaska and the United States is Canada, which also seems huge up here.
Fucking Canada's filled with islands and, you know, all completely broken. It's almost like somebody broke it with a hammer. What's going on?
Canada is a very large country. It's actually roughly the same size as China, but still looks like a colossus when placed in Europe, where it stretches from east to west.
Yeah, isn't that crazy? The geographical way... Just the way we perceive it, is it the way we perceive it, or is it just literally stretched out or looking weird? It looks so weird that it's weird, man.
Portugal to Iran and up north into the Barents Sea just above of Russia. Slightly off topic, Japan is another bigger place than most people believe it to be. If Japan were placed off the U.S. East Coast, it would look like this in comparison. But much, much bigger than Japan, and also not often thought about, is Brazil, which is an absolutely massive country. It doesn't really look like it on our map, but when we move it to Australia, we can actually discover that Brazil is much bigger, which makes Brazil larger than one of the world's seven continents. Brazil is also almost larger than the United States, spans almost all of Europe, but fits rather snugly into Africa.
We're about
to discover that Africa is a colossal continent that we don't often realize.
Isn't it mind-blowing that Africa is so big? It's probably the biggest compared to the China and everything. It's ridiculous, man. This thing is really big. Holy shit.
It can almost fit the entire contiguous United States into just the Sahara Desert, and the continent can also squeeze in China, India, Argentina, Scandinavia, and still
can put a bunch of shit in there, and it will still not cover the whole thing. Oh my god.
Have some room left over. Russia is another place that looks pretty big.
Russia, look
at
Russia,
dude. But dropped down.
Russia is probably the biggest. I can't believe like Russia is that big. I mean, I would expect it to look like USA, but it's like super big.
Africa, she also seems much smaller than what our map was telling us beforehand. While we're still here in Africa, the Democratic Republic of the Congo used to be a colony of Belgium, but Belgium in comparison looks like this. Finally, we need to look at a few other places on the map to the north and the south. Let's start with Sweden, which looks big, but comparing it to Madagascar again, we see that it actually isn't. Iceland also seems like a large island, but it's actually roughly the same size as Tasmania, south of Australia. And finally, we have the white elephant in the room of Greenland, which towers like a behemoth at the top of the map. Greenland masquerades as being a continent in her own right, looking bigger than Australia, South America, and being comparable to North America. But in reality, Greenland is much, much smaller.
And can you believe this shit? Look at this. Greenland is so big, too. Like, Greenland... And I would like to know what's in Greenland. You know, we always like hear it's Greenland, but we don't know what the fuck is in there. It's all does it all look green or some shit? It's weird.
Bigger than Australia, South America, and being comparable to North America.
Yeah, on top, the Greenland looks like it's shorter than most of the things, but it's really big. I mean,
but in reality, Greenland is much, much smaller. The globe reveals Greenland to be the island that she pretends that she isn't, and we get a much more accurate depiction when we compare her to Australia, South America, and North America.
You gotta be shitting me.
We can't forget.
But then why don't they show us a map in which they're of correct sizes? You know, Greenland looking... Why is it looking this big? Shouldn't it be looking like this here? I don't know why it's shown like that. Just because you, show the whole map without the spear, you know, the earth and everything. Just completely flat on the screen on 2D fashion. But you have to show it on their own sizes. Why are they large? And I don't get it.
Forget about the most shy continent in the world that everybody always forgets about, Antarctica, who spends her time hiding away at the bottom of the map. Most people don't truly have a good understanding of the size of Antarctica, which could probably go either way between being larger or small.
Man, something about Antarctica makes me really like creeped out, you know? It's like, ever since I saw the movie The Thing, my mind is like always I think super deep when it comes to Antarctica, and I wonder what's inside the snow and the ice and everything. I wonder what's inside. What else is like completely buried inside the ice? I would love to know, but we'll probably never know. And also, like the Arctic and Antarctic poles are like almost like melting. Is it the sign of like climate change? I don't know, but you know, they're melting, so I guess we'll find out in the future. And we will, you know.
Smaller than you think, but the truth is Antarctica is a huge continent. It is much bigger than Australia. It can stretch all the way from Kiev to Uganda, and incredibly, can be placed between the southernmost tip of Texas in the United States and stretch all the way into the northernmost islands of Canada. There are many more examples like this, but you've probably understood the point by now. The world is both a bigger place and a smaller place than you previously thought it to be. Leave your comments below saying
why
can't
they show them in
the
most in their
true
sizes
that you may have discovered on the map already new on your own. You can check out this brilliant website that I used as a resource for making this video over here at thetruesize.com, and I hope that you'll subscribe to my channel by clicking here if you're interested in watching more content like this in the future.
I love
as always,
the shit.
This was Real Life Lore.
Go check out holy shit, what a fun. Oh my god. Holy shit, that outro music was loud, okay? But what the fuck? Why would they show us in a different sizes of the countries when we were looking at it from the 2D map? You know, it makes no sense. In actuality, they're either small or big, and it's completely weird. I guess it makes sense when we look in a spherical way, you know, and not a 2D flat map. Instead, we should be looking at it in a on a sphere, like buy yourself a globe. I think you'll probably find it anywhere, like even cheap ones, you know, Planet Earth globes. Just you can buy them, and there's like antique stuff which looks really good too, like really pristine, like you know, premium looking and everything. So we need to buy a good globe and take a look at them properly. And this 2D map shit is just stupid, honestly. We should like buy globes to see how every land, and also like the tectonic plates change from time to time, so our lands be fucking moving every time. So we could be closer to merging all the lands, and now we might have like territorial wars because the land has now merged and shit, you know. USA might merge into like fucking Greenland or some shit. We don't know. Anything can happen in the future, and the future is full of like scary shit. And that's why I keep saying, you know, the past has been harsh and the future can be really dangerous. And now is the happiest time, the most peaceful time in the world, in the history of the world, you know. So if you're born at this time of the this planet Earth in on this universe, then you are the luckiest, because if you were to be born in the future, you know, shit will hit the fan, the overpopulation problem, the fucking crazy ass climate change, so many crazy things can happen, and the rise of, you know, technology, AI and shit could be just a mess, okay? And the past was like fucking harsh, and you know, people didn't even get enough food to eat and make a living or anything, you know. So this is the perfect time, you know, just live peacefully, go on money, enjoy your life, man. You know, this is the best you can get. Some people don't even have to earn money nowadays, you know. So we are literally the most happiest time in the universe right now, okay, on planet Earth right now, okay. So this is the good time. Cherish your life, enjoy it. Don't overwork yourself, don't work too hard. If you're passionate, go do it, but don't go crazy, okay. This is the happiest time, and we only got like one life. We don't know if we're gonna be born again, or we're gonna be going to like other like afterlife shit. We don't know anything, okay. So this is the best time, and it looks good, and the map needs to be shown properly with accurate sizes of the countries or whatever. Come on, man, the continents and everything, okay. So yeah, that's a distraction. This is a crazy ass video, a short one, but I hope you really enjoyed it. Not a lot of content is coming up on my channel today, but like 4 videos are coming up. I only upload once a week. week, but I upload like 5-6 videos so that you'll be covered for the rest of the week, okay? If you like this reaction, please subscribe, show me support, and also like suggest me more videos to react. And I'm also losing my interest in doing reactions. I just want to abandon it, but whatever. Please subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.